Greetings, subscribers and other curious persons. I was going to record this vlog last week, but for reasons that will probably be clear once we get into the content of it, I decided to put it off until this week. Now, as some of you might know, I live on the bottom floor of a building. And in June, a leak occurred in one of the flats above us. Now, it took a while for the landlord's agents to track down where the leak was and for the management company to arrange for it to be fixed and to generally get on with things. So in the months between me reporting it and the leak stopping, the plaster work across the bathroom ceiling became mouldy, and then more mouldy, and then began to develop sentience, and then collapsed, leaving bits of plasterboard and coving all over the bathroom. Now, fortunately, we have an ensuite as well, so it wasn't utterly disruptive, but it was a bad enough mold infestation that I suffered respiratory problems every time I went in there, so we had to keep the bathroom sealed until it was fixed. Contingent on this, a second leak broke out in the flat immediately above us, and water cascaded through the ceiling, narrowly missing our bed, but flooding the wardrobe. And again, there was a certain amount of faffing about getting that fixed. So I was not in a particularly happy mood from that. Following on from those two incidents, a contract I was about to enter into got utterly confusticated by the fact that the party on the other side, instead of using solicitors, had attempted to do it all himself. So everything kind of fell apart. So again, not in the best of moods, but the plasterers came out to fix the bathroom. They turned up with instructions to fix the bathroom, but not to do repairs to any of the other water damage to the flat. Not ideal, but I could understand doing it as two separate jobs because it was two separate sources, so you'd want separate bills. So the plasterers turned up, bang up job, turned up, stripped down, waterproofed the room, came back, replaced the plasterboard, waterproofed the plasterboard again, let it dry, came back, painted it. In, out, couple of days work, hardly any disruption. Then the landlord came to look at the property to inspect the current condition. And so I show them the plaster work that's coming off the wall in the front hallway because of unsolved water damage. I show them the plaster work that's coming off in the bedroom due to unsolved water damage. They ask if they can see the repairs to the bathroom. So I say, you have to be a little bit careful because it's still dirty in there, because I've done the cleanup, but there's still plaster dust and the remains of the ceiling the plasterers didn't take away. So the landlord goes in, looks up at the ceiling, which is freshly painted, turns round, runs their finger along the top of the radiator, and goes, "David, this radiator's dirty. It's gonna need cleaning." And by the skin of my teeth, I avoided pointing out in a forceful tone that if they hadn't left 5 months between me reporting a water leak and the ceiling being fixed, the entire ceiling would not have been covered in black mould, and the black mould encrusted plasterboards would not have tumbled down and shattered on the bathroom floor. And even if they hadn't left it 5 months, if the plasterers had taken away the mess after them, I wouldn't have spent 3 days solid trying to scrub gack off the bits of bathroom that hadn't been freshly painted. So really, I thought that the radiator being a little bit grubby was probably good, given that under other circumstances, the bathroom ceiling might have taken the radiator off the wall when it fell down. But so this pretty much filled up my anger stack, which meant that when something else less than ideal happened, I couldn't really focus because there wasn't enough space to focus on being calm. Now, normally this would have been an annoyance and I would have done something to de-stress myself, but it was enough of an annoyance that it threw my writing schedule for the day out, which was enough of an annoyance that the next day I still couldn't focus enough to hit my writing target. So it cascaded. So it took me several days to get myself back to the point where I can unwind enough to get a writing target hit and be calm about the fact that my landlord is an inconsequent wretch sometimes. And so today's video is about the importance of remembering that if you act like an idiot towards someone, there's always the possibility that you will be the last idiot who fell into the bucket, and you will get that entire bucket load's worth of stress vented on you. And also to remember, conversely, that a lot of things go wrong, so it's important to try and de-stress on most of them as fast as you can. And I think that's enough rambling for now, so toodaloo.